can start on getting the video going, then you have 2 more minutes to get it.
We're watching for a herd of cats to arrive. IAC members, thank you very much. For the few holdouts, I'd like to remind you that you can go next door and join up. Today you are in for a treat. Doug Vayda with Southeast Aero for the last 25 years, 17 years, will be speaking, and he will be followed or accompanied by eventually Walter Extra. No more introductions are required. How's everybody today?
Good.
How many people in here have flown an extra aircraft? Well, then we have to work a lot harder. We really do.
Sounds good.
I've been very fortunate to be part of this for 17 years. It's kind of a wonderful thing. I'd like to show you a video that we did for Southeast and, of course, 4 extra aircraft some years ago. But it's pretty fantastic.
Visionaries in
aerobatic aviation. There's guys that seem to think out of the box. Really cool people. The Eggers, Leo, and of course everybody knows probably Kurt Spitz. And now I put Walter in this lineup. All these guys have added a whole lot to our sport. And that's made it much better for us. Walter Extra. This was about a year ago, so he had more hair. Well, Walter started with a mechanical engineer degree, flew for the German aerobatic team. I believe he built one or two pits, I don't remember, and was on the team. He was like all of us. He was a fighter pilot. He was a modeler. But he learned about composites through his college. And he learned about monoplanes. And so in a very short period of time, he came up with a new aircraft, the first airplane, called the Extra 230. He sort of changed the game in aerobatic competition, as we know. No, that's not it. Okay, so we have what we call the Extra Advantage. It's really important that we look at all the different things that have happened throughout the years with extra aircraft. Design parameters have been excellent. Working with engineering is, these guys are really, really good at what they do. The design and performance airplane has always been a big part of what we try to do. They try to change the whole dynamics of flying aerobatics as a whole. Safety, that's probably the key thing that I see Extra work with. He wants to make a safe aircraft. Safe in the air, safe if you're not in the air. It's got to be real resilient, and they've proved to be that way pretty well. Research and innovation. All you have to do is look outside. There's research, and that's innovation. It doesn't get any better as far as I know right now. Some good high points that for me, as I'm an IA, and I know how hard it is to work to getting type certificates, TCs. Extra aircraft currently has 19 countries that recognize the type certificate. That's big. I don't know of any other event company that can say that. As far as Extra, the factory goes, none of you guys have been into a German workspace, but it's surgically clean, it's gorgeous. They have 11,000 square meter production facility near Dinslach in Germany. 60 employees. I've been there like 16, 17 years, and I go there. There's people that were there way before me. They don't change hands very much. It's quite remarkable what they do. Complete tooling. Let me tell you, they can do anything you want there. I mean, it's from the computers to the engineers to how they do the layups, how they do everything. And it's right there in the house. They're welding everything. Quality control, as I say again, it's bar none. They're number one. The closer you look, the better they look. It's pretty fantastic. Over 30 years' experience working with composite. Walter's first airplane flying was in 1980. So it's pretty, you know, they've been working with those products for a long time. He's always on the right on the point, right on the edge of being first. To give you an idea, the Extra 230, there were 13 of them built. I think there's quite a few of those airplanes still flying competition today. And what's amazing is they're actually winning. They're doing well through intermediate and advanced right now. That's pretty fantastic. The Extra 264 were built. If you go to the museum, you'll actually see Patty Wagstaff's on 260 hanging. I'd love to have one of them upgraded. The 200 series, I think how many people, I saw people in here that had 200s or want to buy 200s back then. I think a couple people that I talked to really big. The four-cylinder, two-passenger airplane, they built 47 of those airplanes. Very great. The 300 mid-wings, 68 were built, which was pretty fantastic. 300Ls, I know we have 300L guys in here. Look how many they build those airplanes. And a high majority of those airplanes are still flying us today. The S's, 39 were built. I was surprised that I didn't think that was that many. But I saw Serial 1 fly a couple weeks ago. So that's pretty cool. SCs, that's the wrong number. What number are we up to now? I think 84 or 85. Who would have ever thought that we'd be able to produce 85 single-seat airplanes at the world level? And that's a hot lot for sure. LTs, we've built, I think now, 52. LXs, up to 83. We have the extra 400, which for a time we actually had 400 and 500, and you can see that. So our total of aircraft built by extra aircraft today, that number is actually over 750 now. So that's a whole lot of airplanes going around. We put R&D, we listen to you guys, and we try like heck to make everyone happy. It's very safe, wonderful airplanes. So a lot of people ask me about testing and stuff. I have kind of a funny video. All airplanes, you have to go through all sorts of testing, flutter testing, and all sorts of different type of pressure testing. But Walter sent this to me some years ago, and it was a design test for flutter on the actual aircraft. And you'll have to enjoy the music a little bit, because it's a little bit of humor in that. got a sense of humor when he's going real fast. That's it. So currently we have airplanes that you all know about. They look very good. This is the 330LX. Been a wonderful airplane. We brought the United States some years back. We advertised it as a limited performance in a two-seater. Got a little problems with some of you people out there saying there's no way. And then we had a couple guys making a limited team in an LX. So that stood for itself. Next is the 330LT. We're finding out that airplane has a lot more capabilities than we ever thought. We came out and said it was touring. That was a mistake. We've got guys that have made the advanced team, both here in the United States and Europe, flying an LT. So it really is quite a performer also. The SC speaks for itself. It's the number one unlimited aerobatic airplane in the world today, and it's been that way for many, many years. Probably will be that way for a long time to come, I would think. Bottom line for extra aircraft. International competitions of all pilots over 30 years, ever since the 230 hit, and quite frankly, ever since then, we've been on the top of the stack. It's pretty fantastic. Our position, what can I say? We get compared to, everybody will say, oh, this does this almost as good as an extra. This does this, in their words, oh, this is better than an extra. But we seem to always be in that in comparison. Best resale. I don't know, I've owned probably 10 airplanes in my lifetime. Dollar for dollar, it's been the best, least expensive airplane over time. From the time I bought it until I sold it. It doesn't just die when you buy it. Proven quality record for more than 690 airplanes. What can I say? Anybody in here own an extra? Have any problems with your extra?
Works. Works in a way.
You have any problems with your extra? They just keep licking and keep on ticking. Fully YASA type certificate on all extra. Make sure I'm clear, all extras are certified. The experimental exhibition, once you see them come in, they're just not validated by the FAA. We have LXs that guys decided, hey, we want to put a big engine, big prop, and do some things to it. So we bring them in and they can go to experimental exhibition. But they all are certified airplanes. Even the SC is a certified airplane. Make sure of that. Until facilities and tech staff prepared for long-term professional support. In the last 17 years, I haven't seen hardly anybody go unless they passed on. Saying that now, we have a complete new generation of people coming into the extra group of engineers. They're going to be around for a long time. Proven operation in military and civilian demo teams. Just look around. Phelps teams run them. We've had military teams all over the world that have used our extras in different teams. Saying that, we talked about the facilities and staff preparation long term. I would like to introduce you to some of the people that we work with in extra aircraft. Let me see who we've got here. Well, I think we'll start with the newest member. There was a kid that used to come over to my house. I think Walter would shut off his kids when they were young because I think he got tired of little kids probably running around. There's two boys. There was Eric and Marcus. Marcus Extra is with us today. He just graduated college with a mechanical engineering degree. He's now working with his father full time. So I would venture to say we're going to have a lot of years, a lot of good things. Marcus. Christian Hunker. He is the gatekeeper for extra. I have more arguments with him than anybody in extra, trust me. But he's a good guy. I would like to also introduce a member of our family. I'd like to introduce Chad Graves. Chad sells aircraft in the West. other two sitting in the front, kind of interesting. There's a new airplane sitting out there. I think everybody's seen it, hopefully by now. Designed, you know, Mirko Petrolatti. Mirko is a normal paint job. Mirko is also a full-blown designer. He has designed boats, cars, stereo systems. I mean, it's crazy. And he also was instrumental in that airplane, and he designed that airplane. Pretty cool. And then the guy that I've known and had the honor to work around, I can say with, is Walter Extra. I'd like to give you a this mic, and maybe you can talk a little bit about the new generation airplane, where we're going, and if anybody has any small questions, please feel free. Okay?
Well, now, when I knew this was happening, he was supposed to hold a speech here, and now I see me ending up in his place, but this is done. Thank you very much. Folks, this is a huge event for me personally and for the factory as well. I started serious aerobatic flying in 1980 here at this very place in Oshkosh. That was the world contest at the time. And I was flying my Pitts, which I love, which I always thought is a great airplane. It's always been like that, it stayed like that. This was about my horizon when I came here. Not much experience with the rookie team, and then I saw guys like Ian Lausner in his blazer. I saw Russians with the big, impressive airplanes that they had at the time. Slight disadvantage that they had was that they were excellent pilots, but you could only meet them once because the pilot instructor would give up once in a while. So this was a hard lesson to learn for me because I made friends with some of them. And when I got home, I decided I needed an airplane like the one that Leo is flying. I like the looks. I like, to be honest, the durability that the airplane had. So I thought I'd make something that looks alike, but I had some different idea on aerodynamics. And Doug introduced the airplane that got out of this experience, which got known as the 230. Still today, I don't know why this happened. I didn't cause this. The airplane got known as the 230 whatsoever. And I built it in my backyard garage because I couldn't afford buying one. But I was lucky. The airplane flew, and it didn't only fly, it flew actually quite well. And so other people asked me if I couldn't duplicate this airplane for them. I did that a couple of times, and then all of a sudden the German financial authorities appeared and wanted tax. So I was still studying at this time. I was very lean about all this, but I had collected all the receipts. I gave them to the tax authority guy, and he came back with my opening balance. I got some taxes back, and this started the company. This was 1980. Well, you have heard the story from Doug in between. I'm really glad and I'm really proud to be able to confirm most of what you have said, Doug. So, it's really the case. We have a good team in Germany. We are working together very closely for a long period of time. And we also are maintaining a very close relationship with our American friends, who I've been knowing for many years, and this is more a family business, I would say. And it kind of reflects the atmosphere that I found at EAA. So I'm proud to be a member of this organization and being able to participate and even contribute a little bit to all this. You wanted me to talk about the NG, Doug? Okay, so if anybody is interested, stay. If not, it's going to be in a G now. This is our latest baby. The main difference between what we've been doing so far and this airplane consists entirely of carbon fiber. I was reluctant to use this material for the fuselage for a long, long time because we have these thin surfaces. And as much as there are lots of advantages for carbon fiber, like the IAC module, very high tensile strength, carbon fiber has funny behavior if you overstress it, because once it breaks, there's nothing left. You sit in free air. Whenever in such thin surfaces, like in fuselage tube, you get local exceedances of maximum tensions that would be permissible, you will have a fraction that will not stop, and this may end up catastrophic. So there's two ways. You either add enough material, which puts you on the heavy side in most aerobatic airplanes, most airplanes in general that have been constructed from carbon are do not really have weight advantages. This is good because they were built by responsible engineers who installed enough redundancy. Anyway, I was always happy with the failure behavior of tubular structures, and I didn't want to go away from that. If something breaks in such a construction, then you have redundant load paths, and the forces will be transferred to the remaining structure. Sometimes you will see that something bends maybe or distorts in some way, but most probably the airplane will still get you down and will get you home. I did not want to go to carbon for that very reason for a long time. But Mirko, he lives and breathes airplanes. And whenever you see him, he has a new sketch, he has a new design. Sometimes it looks very weird, sometimes it looks a bit real. And one day he came up with a sketch for an aerobatic idea, aeroplane which showed the genes of what we have been producing so far, but looked a little bit more modern. He is from Modena, modernized the city in Italy, where they produce all these nice fancy cars. Of course, the guy is connected with these people. I mean, you are familiar with the name Ferrari, Pagani. He knows all these people and he's working with them. So sure enough, he is thinking in terms of elegance, in terms of sleek design. And one day he came up with an idea of making a new aerobatic airplane that was very appealing to me. This is like 5 years ago or 6 years ago. And we talked about it, and we said, okay, one day maybe we will look at this project. It took a while till I ran into an idea of improving the failure behavior of carbon fiber. And excuse me if I do not dig deeper in this subject at this point, because I have applied for a patent. And this is still pending. My lawyers tell me I cannot talk about it. If I do, then the patent is gone. So it's going to take a little while, but I'm happy to open up about what I've been thinking as soon as the legal background is confirmed. So I will make this publicly accessible. But this concept grants redundant strength in case of washer failures. This is introduced in the NG, and this opened the option for me to go into carbon fiber thin wall constructions at the fuselage. Well, that was 3 years ago now, and we gradually started thinking about this project. We have a corner in the workshop, our skunk works, where not everybody goes to every day. And for some reason, somehow we managed to keep this project side and get quiet for 3 years. And I'm very happy and very proud that we've made it just in time for this Oshkosh event this year to bring the event. It was a little bit blood, sweat, and tears. We made up our mind to bring the airplane here at a time where it normally was too late to ship the airplane over. And the shipping process was designed in a way that we would have 2 weeks of redundancy to get the airplane here, put it together, and then prepare it for the presentation. Well, in Rotterdam, the first week was gone because our shipping agent missed the boat. The second week went by because customs couldn't find the documents. And then I was about ready to call the container back and put it down the table into an airline and fly it over. But they said, okay, we see a good chance to get it over here in time. Ended up, the container ended up in New York. Kramer made arrangements that it was picked up by a truck immediately. And sure enough, within one day from New York, the airplane was brought here. Our crew put it together, and you see the result out there now. And everybody's welcome to get close to it if you want to. It's the latest design that we have made, and we expect certification in IASA certification in August. So in the real world, this is going to be September, if you want my judgment. The paperwork is turned in, and the authorities are working with it. We have a bilateral agreement with FAA, and we have applied for a validation, so that's also due. No idea when this is going to happen, but eventually it will. Part of our philosophy is that we want certified airplanes, so this is going to be a certified airplane. And I hope you enjoy it. I hope there is room in the air for this little baby, our latest baby, and I would really love to see it flying, people enjoying it. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Walter. So after this is over with, Walter and Mirko both will have some pictures and stuff like that. If somebody wants a signature, wants a picture, wants any of that kind of stuff, just get one. Walter, Mirko, and a little table up here. That you didn't know that either. And you can get a little of that. Some years ago, they came out with the LT. And for me, it was awesome because I love flying airplanes. It seems like it flew quite well, but the one thing that I saw is actually sent me is a little video clip, and it was a Red Bull video clip. You remember Paul Bottom? Anybody knows who that was? The guy was bad. He was great at that. He was bad at that. And he flew quite well. They had the guy Ivanov was flying at that time the extra made a race plane for a couple races. And so they were able to superimpose those two races. And I want you just to show you the difference in performance levels of asymmetrical and asymmetrical. It's pretty interesting. You'll notice when they come in the gate, the edges in front of the extras in back, you can clearly see the edges moving faster. Now the cool thing about the asymmetric wing is how clean it is through the pole. And turn. Now watch this. This will give you a little idea how wonderful that one is. You notice the edge is still going a little faster. Every single pull, he loses a little bit to the extra. Well, that was Walter's. How many races did you do? We did with that airplane. Do you remember?
Red Bull.
With the R, SR.
Just one or two.
But they found that it was going to rewrite everything. So I just want to thank everybody for putting up with me. We're early, so if you have any questions, you can talk to the man. And if you want signatures and stuff, please get them. Everybody be great. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, yeah.